Hi, fire signs, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius, ascendant sun, moon, Venus, rising, and those of you cross-watching, welcome to your tarot love messages. Today we're going to take a look at and see who does the universe want you to be with, who does the universe want you to end up with. Okay, whether this is a new energy or a person who's already in your life as an existing current energy, we're going to take a look at the messages that come up. There's also going to be a part two to this reading, and in part two we're going to dive into those messages in a little bit more detail. So depending what part one reveals to us, we'll explore that in depth in part two of this reading, and that's going to be made available via the extension link below. Now, for those of you that are interested in personalized tarot readings, please feel free to reach out and inquire. I will also be listing my email address just below that the video here where the show more section is. Otherwise, guys, with all of that being said, let's go ahead and take a look and see who is the universe sending into your life. Okay, wow. Bottom of the deck, you have the Two of Pentacles. This is interesting. And below that, you've got the Queen of Swords. Now, for some of you, I feel like maybe this is a person whom you've already crossed paths with. Okay, it just feels like it could be a past energy. It could be a current energy. However, it's a little complicated, right? It feels like things aren't as simple as you want them to be. Okay, you both have very strong feelings for one another, but for some reason things are just not working. For some of you, I do feel like you may be in the process of trying to work through things. Okay, you've come back together, you've reunited here, you've reignited that spark that has always existed between the two of you, and you're trying to work on things. If that's the case, the cards do suggest that you take things slow and steady. You don't ever want to overwhelm yourself or this person here in the process. But for a lot of you, I do feel like this is a past energy, someone whom you still have feelings for one another. And even if this person is currently not in your life, if you're going through a bit of a separation period, no contact, no communication, it feels like the both of you are trying to do, you're doing a little bit of spying on each other, okay? It's in an effort to, in an attempt to try and stay connected to one another. Like they might not be communicating with you, but they'll be checking up on your social media, what you're posting, what you've been doing lately, because that's, to them, it's a way that they still, you know, in a way they still feel like they're in touch. They're still connected here. They feel that connection, and that just sort of reinforces that. Okay, so even if you're not working through things at the moment, and if this is someone whom you still have feelings for and you've separated from this individual here, whether due to time, space, distance, or whether, due to, I guess, this is a complicated state of affairs. State of emotional affairs. It's not so easy. You know, the fact that there are two sides to a coin or two sides to a pentacle tell me that, you know, you have your perspective and you have your intentions and you have your motivations for this connection, and they have theirs. And somehow you guys are just failing to sort of line up with one another. The other thing I get, notice how you've got a fair bit of pentacles here. There are potentially behavioral or emotional patterns that are kind of sabotaging or hindering this connection and preventing it from growing or flourishing in the way that it should. So someone here is holding on to unhealthy emotional behavioral patterns that do seem a little bit toxic or do seem a bit sabotaging here. So either the fact that there is a separation or a distance between the two of you, it may be a good thing, because that might just give you or this person, this energy, some time to work through things, okay? Because it's a fix it and repair it card of the tarot deck. Either you are trying to fix things with this person, this energy. You're trying to work on things, you're trying to work through things, resolve things, or you're also, you're experiencing a separation or a disconnection here, because it's the universe's way of saying you're not ready for this relationship or connection yet. You need to work on yourself, as do they. So I feel like it's important for you to come to an acceptance. If something here hasn't happened in the way that you wanted it to happen, there has to be a reason for it, right? There has to be a reason for it. And for some of you, I feel like you have some work to do, okay? You still have some inner work to do, some inner healing. You have to work on something here. You have to work on yourself. And so do they, simply because that way you can be, the happiest and healthiest version of yourselves, and for yourself and for each other here. Now, if this doesn't resonate for some of you, if you're done with this past person or past energy, then I feel like the message still applies. The reason why you haven't met this person that the universe is trying to send into your life just yet is because you still have some work to do, okay? The reason why you haven't met anyone compatible yet, or you just haven't met anyone that, has swept you off your feet here, is because you still need to work through maybe some past hurts, some trauma, some unhealed emotional wounds. Maybe you need to, patch a few things up here, work through and heal some insecurities, so that when the person steps into your life, you're able to recognize that this is your person, okay? And you're able to recognize that, this is your destiny, okay? And then you're ready, you can be ready, and you can be the happiest and healthiest version here for yourself. So the message still applies, guys, if it isn't necessarily past energy. This is a soulmate, or this is very destined. It just feels like, even if things aren't necessarily working out for you, you have to understand that that too is still a part of the plan and a part of the process of things working out for you here. There's a bit of this, to me, it feels like there's something here that's getting in the way, and it's almost like something is preventing this connection from happening. Either you guys are very far apart from one another, some of you are doing long distance from what I can see, some of you live at a distance from each other, I can see that. For others of you, it's like something here is getting in the way, and even though you've been trying to work on this connection, it's just still not manifesting here. It'll take time. It will happen, but it will take time. And I feel like you have to understand that the reason why this person is your person, but the reason why they're not ready or you're not ready, is because there still needs to be some work done here. And for some of you, I feel like some of this work that I'm seeing is the benefits of focusing on yourself here in the process is so that you're able to know your self-worth, okay? And that you don't accept anything less. Because with relationships, people, they tend to relinquish so much of themselves for their partners because they're already so insecure within themselves to begin with. So that's why, when you are your best, healthiest, and most authentic version, no one can take that away from you here. So take your time here, okay? Take your time to be single, be on your own. Take your time with doing some of this work that needs to be done here. Okay, take your time working through this, complicated state of affairs, working through maybe some of the loss or hurt from whether this relationship, this connection, and from previous ones here. Because if you don't, those issues, they're not going to dissolve or go away on its own. They're only going to surface further down the line and potentially could hinder this again. This is why it's so important, because the cards do indicate a new beginning here with this energy. And it feels like this is someone who is coming back into your life. And much like the Wheel of Fortune, it reminds us that, ups and downs is the rhythm of life, isn't it? Okay. And if you are going through misfortune, or if you are going through some unfortunate situation here, that the wheel will turn, okay, and you'll end up on top again. Like, things will improve here. But from what I can see in the past, there was some very unhealthy and some very toxic, a lot of toxicity in this connection. And what happened is it kind of led to this vicious spiral that was really hard for you to escape from here. Okay, this is why when this person comes back, we don't want the two of you to go back to this pattern that once led this relationship to break down. That's why you need this time and distance apart. And this person is going to come back into your life, or if it's an entirely new energy for some of you, this new energy is going to enter your life when you're ready, once you've done some work. Because if you don't identify those, you know, past hurt, pains, insecurities that we spoke about, they're going to surface down the line and potentially hinder what could be a healthy relationship. So take some time to be intentionally single. Take some time to be, you know, on your own here. Work on yourself so that you can become a drastically happier person here. Some of you, I feel like you need to acknowledge the pain here that maybe has come from this relationship, and I feel like your person may need to be doing the same. It's sometimes it can be very challenging to make space for some very difficult emotions here as they arise, but unless you acknowledge them, they're not going anywhere. And I feel like unless you do this, unless you do the work, and unless your person does the work here, you won't be able to come together in a healthier way, because essentially you're going to go back to some of these patterns that broke the relationship down in the first place. That's why this is so important here. So if there's no contact or no communication, give them the space. More importantly, give yourself some space. Sit with your pain. Acknowledge it as uncomfortable or as painful as it is. Because essentially, whatever has happened here between you and this person, or any previous past relationships for that matter, is so important. And this energy that's coming into your life, this is someone whom you've always had a spark and you've always had a passion with. And that spark here is going to be reignited. It's not going to go away. It's a very, I feel like this is someone who is very youthful, very playful. And this is the type of person who brings out that inner child. And your energy, you know, in your soul, he just plays so well with one another. This is a destined type of a connection. And this is, it feels like it's a soulmate or a soul partner. And if two souls and two people are meant to be together, destiny will ensure that they'll find a way back to one another, even if you guys are at a distance from one another. Don't worry about the details. The universe will fill in the blanks here. I feel like everything is going to come to pass and everything will connect. Everything will make sense in the end. So in part two of this reading, we're going to explore just how things are going to take a turning point. Okay, we're going to explore whether your person is doing some inner work right now. And we're going to explore what will be the future of this connection. Because it has a lot of promising potential, but it's up to you guys to take that potential and make something of it here. I feel like there's still a lot of feelings that the two of you have for one another. And I do see that there is, you know, there's a lot that this person has to offer you. But I feel like I'm getting the message that someone here wants you to love them enough to cover the pain. I don't know if it's you or if it's them here. And that's why it's almost like someone here is wanting to be rescued. And that's why it's important that each energy's here, each individual energy does their own healing, does their own work. Because no one can come along and save you. You need to save yourself. You need to be your, you know, shining, your knight in shining armor here, your own hero. So we'll go ahead and see what this is about in part two of the reading. So follow me via the extension link below to part two of the reading. For those of you interested in a personalized reading, please feel free to connect. Otherwise, thanks so much, guys. Please show your support by liking, sharing, and subscribing to the channel. I just want to thank you all for your time, your energy, your attention. Thank you for reaching out to me for personal readings and sharing your stories with me. And just thank you for your support. It is greatly appreciated.